Hey friends, Azure Functions and API Management, they go together like peas and carrots. And with the recent release of the consumption tier for serverless, API Management is now the best way to manage your serverless APIs. Mike Budzynski is here to show me the latest updates today on Azure Friday. Hey folks, I'm Scott Hanselman, and it's another episode of Azure Friday. I'm here with Mike. How are you, sir?
Very good. How are you?
I'm glad to see you, because thanks, you're going to bring me all the new stuff that's happening in the space.
That's right. Today we are going to talk about three major areas of updates in Azure API Management.
Okay.
First of all, we just released the consumption tier of API Management. It just became available in the last week of May. And that's a fully serverless tier, which is unlike all the other tiers of API Management up to date, which are dedicated. It has all the serverless properties, like billing per execution, etc. It's just a consumption tier for Azure Functions.
Okay.
Now there is no excuse for you not to use API Management if you are building serverless APIs.
True.
Also, if you are using Azure Functions and you are building those serverless APIs with Azure Functions, API Management is now a way of exposing your OpenAPI definition of your Functions applications. That feature is not provided natively in Functions version 2, so you need to use API Management for that.
Okay.
And lastly, we have made it really simple for you to front your Azure Functions applications with API Management right from the Azure portal. And that's what I would like to show you first.
Fantastic.
I have my function app here in the Azure portal. It's an unofficial Azure Friday API application.
Oh, very. We'll make it official after the show.
It has two methods, episodes and people. And now I would like to expose it through API Management.
Cool.
To do that, I can go to Platform Features, click on API Management right here. And this is the interface where I can front my Azure Functions app with API Management. So to do that, I can select my API Management instance, for example, Azure Friday, and expose it as a new API. I can also enable the same Application Insights logging across in the same Application Insights instance.
Okay.
Now I can select all the functions that I would like to import and confirm. This opens the API Management view right in the Functions interface. So we are still in Azure Functions. I can change the display name, Azure Friday API, the suffix, so the URL path. And I can also change the description of my API to, why don't we call it the official Azure Friday
API. We'll make it official this moment.
API.
I love it.
Create.
Okay.
So that's how easy it is to expose your function app through API Management. We need to wait a few seconds until it loads.
Mm-hmm.
And we'll be presented with the design view for your APIs.
This is one of my favorite things. The design view is really nice.
Yes. But we are still in the Azure Functions interface. So mm-hmm. we loaded the API Management interface in Azure Functions app. And now I can add, for example, I can add a policy, which is a course policy. And I need to add it because I need this for the other part of the demo. So I will enable course on my serverless API. And save it. So that's the first area of updates around building serverless APIs. The second area is that we made it really simple for you to enrich your API definition with data model objects. So you can now generate a data model object schema and put it into your API definition.
Mm-hmm.
Not only it benefits you as an API provider, it makes things simpler for you, but also the API consumers, your customers, or the application developers that rely on your APIs, they benefit from it as well.
Mm.
So to do that, I'll go to the test console, still in the functions view. I will go to the test console and test my get people method.
Mm-hmm.
So I will try to fetch a person with the ID Scott from my serverless API.
Okay.
Let's see what I get in the return. Okay, I got 100 okay.
Cool.
And the response is Scott Hanselman, favorite product, Azure API Management.
Very true, very
true. I think that's right,
Yeah.
So as you can see, my API is working. And now I can generate a definition of that object. So
okay.
From a sample, just from testing the API, I can enrich my API definition. And as you can see, I can provide a name for it, for example, people object, and it will contain this sample, but it also contains the automatically generated definition of the object. So as you can see, first name is defined as a string, so is last name, and so is favorite product. And I can save it as part of my response. And that's okay. It. I just enriched my API. Now, coming back to what I mentioned earlier, API management is a way of downloading or publishing your OpenAPI definition for Azure Functions. So I can click this button here to download the OpenAPI definition.
And this standard is consumed by all kinds of tools. You can generate
all third-party, first-party tools everywhere. It's just a very common standard out there in the developer world. Mm-hmm. So this is the JSON documentation, Swagger version 2, right, of my API. And if I scroll down to the getPeople method,
right,
as you can see, it contains a schema, which references to an object which is defined below. Mm. It also contains the example. So actually, the response that I got was automatically put into the schema. So now developers who build applications know what they can expect from this API operation. They can expect this kind of an object, and this is an example. And the schema is located at the end of the file.
That's really clever to have taken the example that we got and then used it as an example and generate almost documentation.
Exactly. It's just to make it smoother for the API consumers. The last thing that I would like to talk about is we have just released a preview version of the new developer portal in API management. Hmm. If you're not familiar with the concept of a developer portal, it's an automatically generated website with the documentation of your APIs. Typically, API consumers go to the developer portal to learn about the APIs, discover them, and then finally get access to them and build applications that use those APIs. Mm-hmm. The new portal is completely built from scratch. It is reimagined compared to the old developer portal. I can launch it right from my API management instance from the Azure portal. And this is the administrative view that's loading up. I don't have enough time to go through all the functionality of the developer portal, but this is the default landing page that you can fully customize.
Wow.
And now I will open the developer portal in an incognito browser mode. So I will open it as an actual visitor, not as an administrator. And now I can explore the APIs that are part of my API management instance. As you can see, there is Azure Friday API here. And I can see all the API operations. If I go to getPeople, I can open the interactive console, the similar console that we saw on the administrative side. It's also there for the API consumers, people who build applications with the APIs. Mm-hmm. And I can call it the same way I called it from Azure Portal. And I would get a response here as well.
That's cool.
Also, the new developer portal is completely open source. It's available in a GitHub repository under the URL apim.ms/apim-dev-portal.
Yeah.
If you go there, you can see the GitHub repository with the source code of the portal.
So that's the source code of the portal that is generated for you?
No, that's the source code of the portal code base. So if you are a customer and let's say the developer portal that we provide is not enough for you, you can extend it however you wish. You can have some developers work on it, implement any custom features that are needed for you, by you, and then self-host your own developer portal outside of your API management instance.
That's so cool. So if you modify the portal and run it yourself in Azure as its own website, does it then call over to the
API? Okay. So the one that we saw was provided with API management instance, but if you require extensions, you can build your own developer portal outside of your API management instance, and it still connects to your API management instance.
So it's not that you generated a portal.
Yeah.
You are calling to the back end
exactly. For
the authoritative API and building from
exactly.
there. Oh, that's nice.
And so that's for the advanced users. And hosting it is super simple. All you need is just a storage card. So you can code on your local machine and just dump the HTML files to a storage card, and that's it.
Oh, really? So it's entirely client-side?
Yeah, it's all static pages, HTML pages with JavaScript. So all the information that is dynamic is fetched on the client-side from the browser using JavaScript.
That is a really lovely upgrade and open source to boot.
Exactly. Not only the developer portal code is open source, so are the issues, documentation, and also the project roadmap, which we'll keep updating. Mm. It's currently in preview. The GA is planned for October-November timeframe. And that's all of the updates that I wanted to share today.
That is really extraordinary. And what a clean bit of architecture there that really puts the customer in charge of their APIs. And it just makes things very nice. There's really no excuse. If you've got a nice developer API, give the people a nice portal for it as well.
Exactly. We want to empower you to create any applications you would like and to create any solutions that you want.
Fantastic. Well, thank you for sharing.
Thank you very much.
I am learning all about some of the great new API management features today on Azure Friday.